Hello everyone. So in today's video, I'll discuss about credit memo. So credit memo is a basically a document that shows that how much amount should be refunded to the customers. Let's say if a customer has ordered something, now he wants to return it, and for that return he wants to have the refund for that. So in that case, Magento's administrator can create a credit memo against that particular order. So in today's video, I'll be discussing about how the Magento's admin can create a credit memo and all its steps. So without any further ado, let's get started. So as you can see, I am in the website, and let me order something, then I'll show you the backend process. Now let me order this bag. Okay, now go to the checkout. So this is a shipping address. Now let me check this money order. And I'm placing the order basically. Yeah, so order has been created. Fine. Now if I click on this order, so if you can see, it's been pending and all. And okay, so now I'll go to the backend. So this is the Magento's admin, and what I will do, I will go to orders and I'll try to locate that particular order. Yeah, so this one, that is 43. So now this is the particular order that we need to consider. Now if I scroll down, as you can see, that was check money order, so that means the payment will be done offline. So as you can see, if you see, it's a total paid is equals to zero, total refund is equals to zero, and total due is $646.40. That means the customer has not yet done the payment. So that means the offline payment basically. So what happens, until and unless the customer is paying for that, or customer has done the payment, okay, so in our case it's offline. So if it has been an online payment, then in that case the total paid would be same as the grand total. Since it's an offline payment mode, so what I have to do, I have to go to the invoices, I have to generate a invoice for that. Okay, so if you see, there's no invoice currently. So now what I will do, I will try to create a invoice of it. Okay, now if you check this, the particular email document will be sent to the particular customer. So what I'm doing, I'm creating an invoice for this particular order. Now when the invoice is being created, now we will see the same order. If I go down, yes, so if you can see, now the total paid is showing is $646.40. So previously it was due, but after the invoice, the total paid has become $646.40. That means the customer has done the payment for this particular order. For that, we have created the invoice, and the moment the invoice is being created, now you will get the option called the credit memo. So now what we will do, basically after the payment, what we do, you can create the shipments, so there is no issue in that. Okay, so I'm not doing shipment for this particular video, so you can do that from your end as well. So basically it's a cycle. So one thing you have to remember, that credit memo is basically a refund document. So until and unless the customer is paying for that or has done the payment, you cannot create a credit memo for that. So as you can see, I've created the invoice. That means customer has paid the particular amount, and now I can create a credit memo for this particular order. So what I will do, I'll click on this particular menu called credit memo. Now if I scroll down, now it has asked me, like, and it has, if there's a, because over here in this particular order there was only one item, so you can do a partial refund as well. Partial refund means if the item, let's say if a customer has ordered 5 items but you want to do a refund of 2 items, so in that case, it is called a partial refund. Now since it's a refund, that means customer will be returning that particular item. So what I will do, the moment he returns it, I'll add that particular item in the particular in my inventory. So that's why I have to check return to stock. Now if I scroll down over here, I can also do some sort of adjustments over here. Let's say if there was any fee and all, okay, so I can do that as well. And since I don't want to do any sort of adjustments and all, so we can you can change whatever values you want. Now if I want to email copy of the credit memo and also want to append comments, what I will do, I will write refund is done, and in bracket of what I will write offline. Okay, so this particular comment I have given for this particular order. Now what I will do, I'll click on refund offline. So since it's an offline payment, so that's why it is coming only a refund offline. If it would have been an online payment, then it would have got a refund online mode. Now what I will do, basically in online mode, what happens, the particular payment gateway will do the moment you trigger an online refund from here in from Magento, the payment gateway will trigger a refund initiation from their own system, and that will be initiated to the customer's account. Okay, so what I will do, I'll click on refund offline. So now see what will like what is going to happen. We'll see that. Okay, now you can see the credit memo has been created. Now the order status has been changed to closed. That means we have done the refund, so order has been closed. And if you scroll down, you see the order item 1, invoice is 1, and refunded has been 1. Now if you see over here, grand total was 646, total paid was also 646, total refund is also done as 646.40. There is no due actually. And the order status has been marked as closed. Now if I go to invoices, so this is done. Now credit memo document is also like it is also generated, and the status is refunded. Now this is the credit memo document over here. Okay, so you can take a printout, whatever you can do from here. And so you can see, if you click on this credit memo, if you see the status of the credit memo, it is refunded. That means the refund amount has been sent to the customers. We have not done any shipments, that is why it is empty. And if you go to the comments history, you will see that the invoice was created, and the credit memo was also created, and when the credit memo got created, the order got closed over here. So at the same point of time, all these three things was done, and the notes are over here. If you see that it is written, we have refunded 6.46.40 and offline mode, and this was the comment that I given over here while I was creating the credit memo. So this is the backend part of credit memo. Where the Magento's administrator will do all such processes. And now if I go to the Magento's front end, that is in the website, that is the front end part. Now if you see, now this is the order product details page which we have already seen. Now if I click on this tab called the invoices, you will get the invoice page. Now if there's another tab called refunds, so whenever the refund will be done, this particular tab will appear, and the customer will be able to see that, okay, so now he has got all the refund for this particular order. Now if I click on this print refund, you'll get a document over here, so you can print it and like for the reference part. So this is what the customer can see from the front end. So I guess, guys, I am able to make you understand what credit memo is and how you can generate the credit memo, and in the same point what the customers will get in the front end, like whatever options when the refund is done, the customers will be able to see the same thing in the website. So I think I'm able to explain most part of it. Anyways, if you have any confusion or any questions or any feedback, you can drop your questions in the comment section. I will surely get back to you. And so I think, yeah, so that's it for today's video. I'll see you in the next time. Bye.